Good evening, Colleyville Heritage Band and families, and welcome to tonight's virtual parent meeting. Tonight, we hope to discuss a good amount of information to get you all in the know and to help you feel prepared for this upcoming marching season. Band the Colleyville Way. The directors took a lot of time last summer to rebrand the identity of our program, and we wanted to put into words what we want for your students and this program. The purpose of the Colleyville Heritage Band program is to empower students to achieve their best while enhancing the quality and spirit of the Colleyville Heritage community. The vision we see is to bring out the best in ourselves and each other. This all seems pretty simple, but it highlights the values we hold highest for your students. We want your student to come out of our program as a better human, not just a better band student. The values we stress the most importance with is threefold: preparation, having your stuff physically and mentally, attitude, and effort. If your student comes to school, rehearsal, or their job with these three values at peak performance, then they will go so far. If you haven't already visited our website, it's time that you become familiar. Our website is ColleyvilleHeritageBand.com. I went ahead and put an image of it right there just so you can see that that's what it's going to look like. Picture day. This Friday, July 28th, we are taking our big group photo for the football program. Due to a delay, our marching uniforms will be coming in later than expected. Because of this, we will be wearing our spirit shirts. Parents, I already sent this in our newsletter, but your student will need to obtain a pair of light-colored khaki shorts. I ask that the inseam for ladies is at least 5 inches to maintain modesty. Specifically for the picture, students will need to wear their spirit shirt, we will hand those out at camp, a black or brown belt, khaki shorts, tennis shoes, and short socks. We don't want any knee-high socks that are distracting from the uniform. Grooming. Ladies, you will put your hair in a high and neat sock bun. Leadership will share a tutorial video on how to wear the hair this week. No wispies means the small hairs that are falling out of the side of your head. Students can slick those back with hairspray or gel. Gentlemen, you need to be clean shaven and your hair should be combed and tidy. This will take place Friday afternoon after we go to section lunches. As a reminder, students will need to bring money on Friday for lunch. Okay, what do I need for summer band? The most important item on this list is at the top, water. Students will get their gallon jugs this week, so for Wednesday and possibly Thursday, new members will need to bring the largest refillable water bottle that they have at home. Our band field is close to the building, so there will be many opportunities for refilling those water bottles. Students who do not bring water are not allowed to participate and will be sent home. Other items to bring are sunscreen, hat, sunglasses, all to protect us from the sun. We encourage students to reapply sunscreen every hour. Students should wear athletic shorts and good tennis shoes. Absolutely no jeans can be worn at practice. Lastly, students will need to bring their music, pencil, their instrument or flag, and their tuner and clip mics. Tuners won't be used the first week, but we will need those for music blocks starting next week. Taking care of yourself. Remember that our first value is preparation. Students need to prepare for band camp by being hydrated ahead of time. If at any time a student feels thirsty, then that is an indicator that they are already dehydrated. I suggest drinking water immediately when you wake and drinking water before bed. This will help tremendously. Additionally, we have a 5-minute water break every 30 minutes we are outside, and students should take advantage of this time and drink plenty of water. If the heat index exceeds 100, we increase the water break time. This information and specifics about this can be found on our website under our summer band heat plan. Do not skip meals. Students should arrive to band camp already have eaten breakfast, even if they don't normally eat breakfast during the school year. Band is a very physical activity that requires nourishment. Gatorade is also encouraged, as we lose a lot of electrolytes when we sweat outside. Sunscreen is a must because skin damage can negatively affect a student's entire band camp experience by not being prepared. Do not try to be the hero. If a student does not feel well, they should immediately inform an adult. All of the band directors are certified in CPR, AED, and adult first aid. We can safely assess a student and determine if they need to sit out or go home. 100% of the students sent home last year sick have done so because they have not followed our recommendations or they have pre-existing conditions that we did not know about ahead of time. So parents, if your student has a pre-existing condition that is affected by being outside, please let us know immediately. Taking care of your stuff. Every band student at Colleyville Heritage has been assigned a locker for their use. All students are required to lock their lockers with a combination lock provided at home. Target and Walmart sell these for less than $5. The due date for locks is this Monday, August 31st. Lockers are meant for music, instruments, marching equipment, clothing, and other personal belongings. Our students deserve a safe place to store their things. Parents, some of you spent quite a bit of money on the instruments your student plays on, and those need to be protected. Summer band rehearsal schedule. I attached a year-long calendar in the email I sent this afternoon, but for specific times, you will need to find our band calendar. Go to our website and click on the calendar tab. Our calendar's default is on the week view so that families can plan ahead each weekend. Please take some time to familiarize yourself with the calendar. Absence policy. It takes a lot of hard work from the students in our program to do what we do, and we need everyone here to make it happen so we can do our best. Of course, absences happen. We just need to make sure that we are clear on what we expect of our members. Students can be excused from a rehearsal if they fall under the following reasons: religious holy days, student illness rendering them incapable of observation or participation, and a director-approved family emergency. If your student is well enough to attend school, then band is an extension of that. Here are a few examples of unexcused absences: getting called into work or not finding cover for a work shift, a birthday party, concert tickets, and tutorials without notice for directors to arrange options with teachers. We take tutorials and academics very seriously, and we encourage students to attend tutorials as much as possible outside of band rehearsal. Of course, academic emergencies happen, and that requires a student to miss a portion of rehearsal sometimes. We deal with those on a case-by-case basis. We are here to be your student's advocate to their teachers, and we want to help them do their best in all of their classes. Regardless of the reason your student is missing, is excused or unexcused, we must hear from you. Please email myself, Mrs. Hunt, with any future conflicts that may arise. Freshman orientation. Our band-only fish camp will take place on Friday, August 18th. We have a few students in the band program that are also members of an organization called PALS. PALS students run the Colleyville Heritage General Fish Camp. Because Colleyville Heritage Fish Camp overlaps with our band camp, we have arranged a private tour and schedule pickup for our 9th grade band members. Students will eat lunch together and find their classes so that they are ready for the first day of school. Band students who are in the 9th grade will not attend the advertised fish camp or orientation that morning. Parents also do not need to attend fish camp. Itineraries page. This is a somewhat new feature we added to our website last year. Anytime we have an event that your student needs to know the details of, we put it up on our itineraries page. If you look now, we've already put up the itineraries for our first few football games. This is a great resource for families because it details information like when, where, and most importantly, what to wear. It's extremely valuable and is probably our most looked at page of the website besides our calendar. Student drop-off will be a little different this year. Because they are building the new indoor practice facility on our grass field, the band has been temporarily moved to the parking lot for the 2017 season. That means there will be a few places where parents can no longer pick up or drop off their student. Because it is unsafe, parents, please do not enter in the northeast corner of the student lot. I went ahead and marked that on the map for you guys. Parents can safely drop off their student in two places. First, in front of the band trailer, where most of you probably already drop off your student, and then if you'd like to go through the student lot on the south side, you can drop off near the mini band trailer in the parking lot. Be sure to avoid the band field that I have boxed out. Exit south to safely avoid the band students. Thank you for putting the safety of our students first. Panther Pride Night Pep Rally. every year the community has a pep rally to kick off this year's football season. This year, it will be held on Saturday, August 19th in the main gym. Students will meet at 6 p.m. in the band hall. Dress will be spirit attire, the same as what we wore for the band photo. Only girls can wear their hair down or up, whichever they choose. Students will need to bring their instruments and music, and I expect that the event will end by 7:45 p.m. Band and Diamond seniors will also be recognized this night as well. Okay, save the date. We are having our annual show debut and barbecue dinner on Friday, August 18th. That is the Friday after the first day of school. Students will perform at 7:30 p.m. The directors will be able to take this night to fully explain some of the details of our 2017 production, Cosmos, and we will let you know what to look for when watching. Afterwards, we will enjoy barbecue in the Panther Den. Information will go out soon about purchasing dinner tickets. Football games. All Diamonds and band members are required to attend every football game of the 2017-2018 season. They are by far the most social and fun part of our season for our students, and they give students a performance opportunity at halftime. We have 10 regular season games total, 5 home and 5 away. Most games occur on Friday nights, but 2 will be on a Thursday and 1 will be on a Saturday. After the regular season, our football team enters the playoffs. Last year, our football team went 4 rounds into the playoffs. The corresponding date for the 4th round this year would be Saturday, December 9th. Just want to give you guys a heads up on that one. Marching contest. We primarily compete in the month of October. August and September are about learning the show, refining it, and October is about the competition. We will attend 4 Saturday competitions: Broken Arrow, Birdville Marching Invitational, U.S. Band Southwestern Championship. This one will also be a very short day for the kids, and then Area Marching Contest on October 28th. In order to qualify for Area Contest, we need to score a 1 or superior rating at the UIL Marching Contest on Tuesday, October 17th. Once that happens, at Area, for every 5 bands that attend Area, 1 band will advance to state. So, if 20 bands attend, 4 bands will advance. If 19 bands attend, only 3 will advance. If we make one of those top spots at Area, we will qualify for the state marching contest in San Antonio. Just so you know, the Colleyville Heritage Band has not attended state marching contest since 1996. We are hoping to break that streak this year. We're very excited. Standardized testing. With our competition schedule, we have conflicts with our October test dates. Students will not sign up for the October 7th SAT or the October 28th ACT. You can see the approved dates below. I should note that there is no SAT test offered in the month of September, so students should take advantage of the August date. Registration for that ends July 28th. Private lessons. Most of the students in the Colleyville Heritage Band program are enrolled in private lessons. Teachers come to Colleyville Heritage and give the lessons here on our campus. They are badged and background checked through the district. The district determines the rate for lessons at $20 per half hour. Some financial aid is available for families that show financial hardship. Students who are enrolled in lessons have greater success in our concert auditions. They earn the top spots in all region and earn top marks at solo and ensemble. They also have more purpose and show a greater investment in the program. I cannot recommend private lessons enough. For the list of our private teachers, please find the private lessons tab under the home on our website. Communication. If you did not already know, I, Mrs. Hunt, send out the weekly Colleyville Heritage Band newsletters. These keep you up to date on what's going on and any changes that may be occurring. If you are not receiving my emails, please contact me so that we can update your information. Our students communicate on an app called GroupMe. It's a large-scale group messaging app that keeps your students connected to one another. It's such a valuable resource. Because of it, your student will be informed and connected to their peers. If they're not on GroupMe, I highly recommend that you let your student get on that. We also have a Facebook and Instagram page. This year, we hope to restart the band Twitter page. If you would like to receive text alerts for the Colleyville Heritage Band, please follow the instructions on the right. We have a Remind that sends out marching band info, mostly when to pick up your student or if something changes last minute, and our boosters also have a Remind. We do not send reminds very often, probably about once a week, so the information that is sent is extremely valuable. Listed right here is the contact information for all of the band staff. I also went ahead and put Shauna West down there at the bottom. She is our band treasurer. She will help you with all things pertaining to your band account. If you have a question, big or small, please do not hesitate to ask. We typically answer all emails within 24 hours and most of them within 12 hours. Thank you so much for watching tonight's virtual parent meeting. We are excited about this year's season and we are thankful for your continued support of the Colleyville Heritage Band program. Thank you so much.